Good morning, all of you. Wishing all of you happy Independence Day. Sorry for troubling on this day also. They have kept working on this day also. Then, so we'll continue with some more problems on the moisture EMF. Okay, read the question now. A variable magnetic field creates a constant EMF in a conductor ABCDA. So here the B bar is varying in such a way that it will produce a constant EMF E in the loop, this total loop that is equal to E. And there's also another loop is there. He has given resistance. The resistance of the portions ABC R1 CDA. This is R2. And this one is AMC will be R3. And there's a meter. So it's an ammeter. What is the meter? It will be like an ammeter, which will measure the current. Now, there are two loops are there. No? So here is what magnetic field is present. There is no EMF here. So there is no field here. No magnetic field. Now, let's have some first, what all conditions given. No magnetic field. Here field is present. This is a magnetic field. Varying. Well, the net EMF induced in this will be E. So here I'll draw the circuit. So this should be RABC, RCDA. This will be RABC, the resistance. And let this EMF be E1, let this be E2, and the resistance of other part is how much it is RAMC. What should be the net EMF? E1 plus E2 should be equal to E2. That's what the condition given. E1 plus E2 should be equal to E, that one. There is no net magnetic field linking the other loop. So what should be the net EMF? It should be zero. So therefore, how E3? The E3 should be, shall I put in opposite direction here? And what is the basic condition here? E1 plus E1 minus E3 should be equal to zero. Net EMF induced should be zero. That one is asking what is the current through the meter. Now you can go for KCL, KVL, whatever be that. So let this be I1, let this be I2, I3. Solve this right loop equation. E1, E2 are unknown. So everything answer should come in terms of E only. Write down the equation. So this is, I think, R1. Let me write according to the given symbol. Why the polarity should be like this, E1, E3? Because net EMF induced should be zero. So therefore, the polarity we should take in this way. And where is the meter? The meter is here. Let me introduce that meter here. So what is the reading of meter is what? I3. What about direction of I3? Can we assume like this? Anything, no? It's just a KCL, no? Yeah. Or if you want to put it in this way, anything. You solve it, if you get I3 negative, change the direction. I'll write down the magnitude of I3. So check later on. No? This is only the idea. So can be asked with more than one loop. From yesterday, I was stressing it. Can be asked here. Just I picked a problem to reflect that basic concept.
Sir, how did you write E1 minus E3 is zero?
Because there's no magnetic field here, no. Net EMF induced is zero in this loop. This is very important, no? because there is no source of varying magnetic field in this region here. Okay. Okay, we take the next question. Please do revise. Means not possible for advanced. Definitely they will ask you, so you should be very careful. Okay, now we'll see with the cavity also. Read the question. Meanwhile, I'll draw the diagrams. This is the region where there is no magnetic field. Magnetic field is present only in the other part. What shall we? What is the best way of doing this problem? Is no magnetic field here, no field. No magnetic field here, magnetic field is present. Can I assume this to be made up of like this? Here B bar is into the plane. Here B bar out of the plane. The resultant of those two, what we get? We get a region without magnetic field, superposition. So we did so many, started from where? Center of mass, moment of inertia, gravitation, then electrostatics, then capacitor, then electromagnetism, then again in EMI chapter also, then Ampere's circuit law. There also we brought cavity. The similar idea is what we are bringing. So what I'll assume is that no magnetic field region, how to assume that one? Here the magnetic field, let it be outward. The superposition of these two, what do we get? We get the no magnetic field region. There's a basic method of solving this problem. So still, if you find difficult, you can assume that there is a cylinder. This R by 2, B bar into the plane, B bar out of the plane. So here B bar, it is varying, it is a constant rate, dB by dt. So call that dB by dt as alpha. Now you directly come to the discussion. So let this be the point somewhere inside. So here at this particular point, we have to find out the field. So I'll take it out this. So this will again will trouble you. No, come for this one. So what is the induced electric field at this point? How you write? B bar into the plane. Everywhere B bar is present, I'm showing only one dot. B bar into the plane and there's a point O1 and there's a point P. They cannot be in same direction. The point PLL, I'll give it here. This is a point P, and for this it will be radially take like this and all. So this is O2. Now what should be the direction of induced electric field at point P? Perpendicular to this R1 bar. That's all, no? O1 P bar is what? R1 bar, and perpendicular to that will be E1 bar will be directed. Let me take with the black color one. Now B bar out of the plane. Again, here also the B bar is varying with the time. The superposition of these two is what? We get the first diagram. Able to make it out? This is like a cavity here. Now what should be the B bar at this particular point? Should be perpendicular to R bar. So this should be B2 bar. Call this is R2 bar. This is P2. Now show everything here. How B bar due to this will be somewhere the point P is here. Due to this, E1 bar, and this is R1 bar. Now come similarly, show due to this one. So this should be the R2 bar. And it should be directed perpendicular to this vector. Don't show opposite to E1. It cannot happen. Am I right? You can see. Now let's write first E1, E2. What are E1, E2? From the diagram, what should be the E1? The point P lies inside the magnetic field, no? E should be equal to alpha R by 2. Am I right? So what is the basic formula? E1 into 2 pi R equal to effective area pi R square dB by dT, which is equal to pi R square alpha. So what is E1 is equal to R alpha by 2. Similarly, the E2 also I can write it. So this should be the R1. In exams, better remember some data, no, of like this, really going to help you a lot. Why E2 should be opposite towards right? B bar is out of the plane. By Lenz law, negative positive flux increases, d phi by dt positive, EMF induced negative. Negative means anti-clockwise, so therefore the E2 should be in that direction. Now what I should do, I should take subtraction of this one, no? The resultant field, because when I place this cavity, this one here, then what happened? I'll get this one. So the resultant field at that particular point, what happened? Should be E1 bar plus E2 bar, or I should subtract, or shall I add?
Add.
See, this is what field produced by the cavity. I should take algebraic sum better. This is due to cavity, no? If I bring this second diagram, if I place it here, then what do we get? We get this one. So the field, I should place this cavity at this particular point here. Then the field, what happened? These two will get nullified. Then the field will get nullified here. So tell me like how the resultant field will be now.
Downwards.
Should be directed O1, O2. So here, let's write the in vector form. This should be E bar equal to E1 bar plus E2 bar. So this will be alpha by 2 R2 bar plus alpha R1 bar plus R2 bar vector. I should take the resultant of these two fields, no? It should be the, so now R2 bar is vector like this here. So it should be, because I should subtract, then only we'll get it. R1 bar minus R2 bar, what we get it? According to the vector, so triangle, this is R1 bar. This is R2 bar, minus R2 bar will be in this direction.
Sir, how did you write?
Wait. Alpha by 2, O1, O2 bar. O1, O2 bar is a fixed value, no? And alpha is a fixed value. So how the direction of induced electric field everywhere in this particular cavity, it will be vertically directed and it'll be constant.
How did you write A1 bar as alpha R1 bar by 2? It is not in the direction of R1 bar.
Sir, it should be R2 cross K cap, sir. 2 cross minus K cap and R1 cross.
It should be R1 bar cross something like B cap, or we have to define some vector and then put that there.
Okay. That one. In the vector form, you are okay. This one. I'll do one thing.
And
I'll do one thing.
Add, sir, and when we add, because the direction is changing, that is why the minus sign comes, but we should write E1 bar plus E2 bar only.
Okay, directly I wrote, no? Okay, the vector form, if you want it, E bar should be R1 bar cross some vector, huh? The resultant of that should be that one. B bar is also there, no? DB bar is also there. Okay, in the vector form. Yeah, this should end up with vector form. E1 bar, E2 bar. E1 bar will be directed. So in the vector form, it will be. The resultant field will be E equal to. From here we'll proceed it here. This one. So the direction of E bar will be perpendicular to R1 bar. That is one. So this is only magnitude. So I'll take another vector which is perpendicular to plane. R1 bar cross B bar. Into the plane I should take it. B bar is into the plane, no? So if you write in vector form, DB bar by DT will be into the plane. Here DB bar by DT for this will be out of the plane. So again, it will be very lengthy process.
Just will write B
assume
cap.
One vector.
B bar itself is a vector. With respect to that only we should write it. In the vector form.
R1 bar cross B cap we can write, sir.
DB bar by DT cross DB bar by DT cross DB bar by DT we should write it, not some other vector, it should be B bar only. DB bar is into the plane, no? So we'll get it R bar cross B bar. Okay, E1 that will be out of the plane. Yeah, that will come. So B bar will become minus DB bar by DT. Okay, I'll write it one. Now in the vector form, this should be R1 bar by 2 should also be there, no? Is that okay? Minus of this will be. I need some space. I'll write it down below here. Yeah. This should be of R1 bar cross DB bar by DT. r2 bar cross minus db bar by dt, you should write it. Why negative sign? The field in the cavity, this should be out of the plane, this into the plane. So this, if you take it, of db bar by dt, of into, so minus sign will adjust for this. This will be r1 bar minus r2 bar cross db bar by dt. Check it now in the vector form. R1 bar minus R2 bar should be O1 bar O2 bar. Or straight away you can write it also. So this should be the dB bar by dt. So this should be equal to of dB bar by dt is alpha. Or we'll write only magnitude. This should be equal to alpha O1 O2 by 2. And the angle between them will be 90 degrees. In the vector form, it should be like this. And the angle between them will be 90 degrees. So this is the expression for the induced alt field, and it will be directed along line joining the center of the cylinder to center of cavity. Not advisable, this formula. Okay, anyway, like because the requirement of question, I have brought it. This you make observation. So like this will happen. A cavity will also come. Please be careful. So it's not defined in most of our books. Can be possibility of asking the above problem and this one. Come for next application. This is just I'll explain question. It'll be much easier. Very lengthy explanation is there. There's a rod. About this rod open, the disc can, the charger ring can rotate, and also there's a non-conducting disc can rotate. So I'll take a rope or a string, I'll wound on it. Then I'll suspend a block of mass M. Then there's a charger ring, charge is present. Let lambda be the linear charge density. Charge is present here. Let M1 be the mass, A be the radius, M2 be the mass of disc, and B. This is a neutral, there's no charge. So here I'll switch on a uniform magnetic field B naught T, which will be directed perpendicular to plane of the ring and also parallel to the axis. Then for equilibrium, what should be the value of M? How things are related here. So now let's variable magnetic field links. It will produce induced electric field. No? The induced electric field acting on the ring, will it set up any torque? Yes, that torque will be set up above this rod. And that torque should be balanced by torque due to the weight setup that is acting on the disc here. That's the overall the question. So now take away this induced electric field. Application is what we have to go for it. So I think diagram I can show. Yeah. See once. A non-conducting charger ring of linear charge density lambda, mass M1 and radius A, and a neutral non-conducting disc of mass M2 and radius B are free to rotate about a horizontal rigid rod passing through their centers as shown. Uniform magnetic field B called B naught T directed perpendicular plane of ring is switched on. Find the value of mass M of the suspended block for equilibrium. Directly come for the ring. Take help of only the ring. So what are the forces that will be acting on the ring? So you convert this into some plane diagram. This is a ring. So where charge is present? Charge is present on the circumference only. And the radius of this is A. And there's a uniform magnetic field which is varying with the time. Will it set up any torque? Induced electric field in what direction will be? B bar into the plane. I'll magnify it. B bar is into the plane. What direction the induced electric field here will be? Will it be tangential? What is the value of E? E into 2 pi R or 2 pi A equal to pi A square dB by dt. So this should be A B naught by 2. Now you assume a small element. Assume a small element. The small element will have a charge dq. It will experience a force df. So what is that force? Df equal to E into dq. So this should be equal to A B naught by 2 into dq. Will it set up any torque about the center O1? There'll be torque acting by this force. So df is equal to into A. So A B naught 2 dq into A. A square B naught by 2 dq. So let's go for the total torque acting on it. What is the total charge on it? Q. So A square B naught by 2, total charge is Q. So we have lambda. Lambda is what? Q by 2 pi A. Linear charge density of this is given lambda. So A square B naught by 2, Q will be lambda 2 pi A. Substituting all this, 2 will get cancelled. So pi lambda B naught A cube is what the resultant torque acting on the ring. In what direction? What is the sense of this torque? Will be like this. Is it okay? Torque due to induced electric field. Okay, fine now. So any questions will come now. Many questions are there. Please do, like a ring kept on a rough surface, then time varying magnetic field B equal to B naught T square switched on. Find the time after which the ring starts rotating. How to calculate the torque? This one. The B naught will be as a function of time. 2 B naught T will come here. Then if it can overcome the torque due to friction mu mgr, it starts rotating. You do have a problem in most of the books. Do work out. Very popular. Many teachers will try to that one. Even in advance, they may ask you because something with friction, they're trying to ask that one. So the same concept, if there's a ring, let me cover that idea here also. So there's a B bar. B naught T square. And there's a ring like this where charge is present on the circumference. Kept on rough surface. Then torque due to this, how much it will come? 2 B naught T, dB by dt should be 2 B naught T. So torque due to induced electric field should be 2 B naught T pi lambda A cube. When it will start rotating? When it overcomes torque due to friction. What is the torque due to friction? Mu mgr. After this time only, the ring starts rotating. Non-conducting. How to calculate torque due to friction? You are already aware in the rotation mechanism. Directly I'm writing mu mgr. And let's come to the problem. So how do this torque due to ring will be, will act in this sense? The torque due to this weight suspended, weight mg will act here. String will be taut. So this will set up a torque in this direction. So for equilibrium, what you should write? Torque due to ring should be torque due to weight. Simple application. Only thing is you must have that basic idea of induced electric field. This should be equal to mg into b. Pi lambda B naught A cube by GB. This should be the answer. This is another thing, something related to the other concept. ring placed on rough surface. After what time it start rotating? For t less than this value mu mg bar by 2 b naught pi lambda a cube, the ring will be attached. After this time, the ring starts rotating because the torque due to individual twigs should overcome the friction. You do have all application. Now, straight away, application problems of individual field. Due to individual field, there will be torque. That torque, you are going to link with rotation mechanics problems. Now, suppose if the mass of the suspended block greater than this, so what happened to the system? It will start rotating. The net torque will be non-zero. I can introduce other ideas now here. Instead of string, I'll suspend a spring. Then spring force and the weight will come into picture. Just multiple ways you try to analyze. Okay, I'll say goodbye to induced electric field. Rest all problems you should manage. Almost maximum ideas I shared with you. Any other logical question, you'll bring it because there's an unlimited topic. Similar to Ampere's circuit law. So in exams, you be careful. Okay, let's take the different types of the loops here. A close, so spiral coil is there and the magnetic field is varying with the time. So what is the EMF? What is the EMF induced in the coil is asking. The EMF induced in the coil. Look at, it's a spiral. Somewhere you'll come across this in magnetism chapter. In the magnetism chapter, we have come across this condition. The loop will be of now different shape. Already we have seen triangle or other things. Come for this. So this is the inner area A, outer area B. So what shall I do for this? B bar everywhere into the plane. I'll assume a strip. I'll assume a strip of width dr. N number of turns are there in a width b minus a. So therefore this will be n number of turns per width b minus a should be equal to dn by dr. So dn is equal to n b minus a into dr. Then first, what is EMF induced in this strip will calculate, or flux linking this strip d phi. Flux linking the strip. So I think all of you know, can I call this as a strip, circular strip, rectangular strip? So the strip, so let this be d phi. So what should be the d phi? Should be equal to b into dA into dB by, oh, so later on I'll come to this one. So what is dA? dA should be equal to 2 pi r dr. But how many turns are there? dn turns are there. So what is the total flux linking? So I should write dn, no? Try to see the dn, dA, b. If n turns are there, the dn should be written here. So therefore, this dn will be equal to n b minus a dr. So here 2 pi r dr. I think somewhere we are going wrong. Tell me what I should do with this. Two drs, if they come, we can never integrate. Everyone know this. What has to be done? There's a typical way what we proceed. Where we are wrong. You should bring your mathematics into picture. Nothing to do here. You have to bring your mathematics into the picture. I only wrote first flux, then I'm going to differentiate. But two drs outcome. So somewhere our there's a problem with our mathematics. Nothing to do with concept. We know Faraday's law, we know Lenz's law, and we know also some basic math. So somewhere the assumption of things are going wrong here. So here, I'll just chop it. So this should be this one, rather than thinking like this, no? Yeah. Flux linking the strip. You're supposed to do like this here. There's a ring. There's a ring, that one. What is the number of turns? Number of turns per unit width is what? N by B, no? So I'll bring everything like this. So let me bring small n. Small n to picture. This is a number of turns per radial distance. Number of turns per radial distance. We'll define quantity like this. So let me go for the flux linking d phi is equal to in a circle of radius r, pi r square, the magnetic field b into n dr. I'll write it.
Sir,
look at this.
Wrote one equation. In that, why did you write dA? You have to write area enclosed by this loop, not the area of the loop.
I think I that's why I told you, no. So two drs have come. You see here, I changed it.
Okay.
I changed it, no? Yeah. So this should be the pi r square b is b naught t, n is and it's a constant, no? I'll bring it later on. So therefore this will be pi n b naught t r square dr. This I'll differentiate now, so I'll get emf induced in this. Then EMF induced first in that particular strip there. Then I'll integrate from A to B. Then I'll get the total EMF induced. So this is differentiating pi n r square dr b naught. Differentiating. So this is what? So call this is dE.
Sir.
I'll finish off. Then. Huh? Because others, they'll get confused. So this will be, let it be A to B. So pi n B naught R cube by 3 A to B. The value of this should be pi n B naught by 3. B cube by A cube. So what is n? N, you substitute the value. N by B minus A. Okay, now.
Okay, sir.
Okay, different types of structures will come. You should be very good in your basic maths. Huh? Nothing to do with Faraday's law or anything. Everyone knows Faraday's law equal d phi, but it's over. Nothing wrong in the first way, what I thought. Definitely what went, two drs will never come. So what went wrong? Somewhere the mathematical assumption went wrong. Then come and correct it. See, nothing wrong. So you learn by mistake. How to learn by my mistakes. First time when you take it, no? So there's arbitrary way of thinking. So coils will come. Number of turns. If all the turns, if B is almost equal to A, then no problem. It's quite easy. But if the width is comparable, no? If the width is not negligible, then you should think in this way. Take next one. Parabola. This is a rod. Parabolic curve. read the question. I'll put the diagram. This is the and this is the rod. Okay, thin rod. Okay, get into the problem, read the question. So somewhere look at the rail. This is that rail, parabolic rail. And this is that rod. It is moved now. So what is the EMF? The EMF induced across the connector as a magnitude in terms of Y. It's asking EMF induced across the rod. Fixed rail. So as the rod moves, the rod will have displacement like this. So as the rod moves, so look at the B bar into the plane. As the rod moves, so what happened to flux linking the loop? So what is the loop? Loop is formed like this, no? OA, CB. OA, CB will form a loop. What the area of correction of the loop keeps on increases, flux increases. So d phi by dt, EMF will be induced and there'll be induced current will flow. Let R be the resistance of the rod. So in fact, resistance of the rod keep on increase. We are not bothered about the current. We are bothered only EMF induced. And how to bring that one here? What mathematics you have to bring? So now flux is varying. No? So let me assume an elemental strip. I'll assume an elemental strip. First flux linking that elemental strip. D phi, so let the x is equal to and let it be y and this will be dy. B bar everywhere into the plane. So what is the area of the strip? So dA is equal to 2x into dy. And what is y? Y is equal to we have kx square. I think you can manage now. So here, what is v equal to dy by dt, no? The velocity along y-axis with a constant acceleration is telling. Let's write later on. So we have this much here. So what is the flux linking it? D phi equal to b into dA. So b 2x dy. I'll differentiate this, but we have x also. So what shall I do with x? Can I replace with this x equal to under root of y by k. We'll differentiate this. We'll get expression for EMF induced. And what I should write with the dy by dt? The dy by dt is what? The v. D phi by dt equal to 2b root k. Y dy is there. Root y dy there, so this we have to differentiate. How to bring this? I think we can't do like this, no? Or if it were in terms of y, we would have differentiated already. Dy is there, then this y there, d square y by dt square will come if we differentiate. And d square y by dt square is what? The acceleration. Can we do? Okay, this will be root y d square y by dt square plus dy root of y. y to power of 1 by 2 minus 1 dy by dt. Somewhere.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, if you differentiate like that, then it will become d square phi by dt, no, sir. Because d phi is already there.
I'm differentiating with respect to time over, no? D phi by dt. Let me end up with mathematics. Let's see that. D square by dt square is acceleration. Keep it here. Dy into dy by dt is what? V. So this will become dy by root y equal to, that they should be, 2 will also come. Dy by dt is what? V.
Dy by dt, sir.
Dy by dt, no? That is V, no?
That one also dy by dt, sir.
This one,
huh? Dy by dt whole square.
Okay, what I did, let me check it. Dy by dt whole square, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me do it. This dy is one function, root y is one function, no? UV method I applied.
Sir, you differentiated d phi, no, sir? Sir, if you differentiate d phi, what we get is d square phi by dt, no, sir, not d phi by dt. If we differentiate phi, we get d phi by dt.
Okay,
we are differentiating d phi, we are getting d.
D5, I should. The flux linking elemental surface area. Okay, fine. Yeah. Some assumption I think I went made wrong.
Sir, first if we integrate with respect to y, then we'll get the expression for phi, then we should differentiate.
Okay, that one. I think I made some. Yeah. I should find out flux, no? I think I go on somewhere in either way. First, we'll calculate the flux linking this area, then flux as a function of x and y, then we can do further. So this will be elemental area dA. dA is equal to 2x into y. Till here, okay, fine. 2x equal to 2x into dy. So we'll take this one. Y is equal to, what is the equation? Kx square. So dy is equal to 2kx dx. Yeah, dA is equal to 2x, this will be 2kx dx. So dA will become 4k x square dx. I'll integrate 0 to x, then area will be 4k x cube by 3. Okay, fine. So this, now the flux linking will be B into A. 4bk x cube by 3. dy by dt is what we know. So this x cube will convert into y. Y equal to kx square is there, no? So this should be 4bk by 3. Y to the power of y by k to the power of 3 by 2. Now I'll differentiate. I think now okay, check it. 4bk by 3 y to the power of 3 by 2. Check once calculation. solving this, we'll get the required answer. Option C. Okay, this is something. So first flux linking that we have to calculate because two DeFi's I brought it.
So the before method is also correct or not, sir?
D square y by dt square will come into picture, no? There, the acceleration again we have to
define, sir.
No, there's a flux linking elemental surface. Then what happened? We should integrate that. Just wait. Are you able to hear me, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So screen stop, would no? I'm here. I'll bring the screen right here. Able to see screen?
Yes, sir.
Not responding. Okay, no, so there's a thing. So check the EMF induced. Constant acceleration is asking. So further velocity, what happened? You can write it as, in terms of A, you can bring it. Do calculation. Okay, read this question. So it's a very, very simple one is there. The two rails are there. So this is the first rod and this is the second rod. Full screen not there. Okay, you want full screen. B bar into the plane. These are again, take help of some very good application problems are there. So this initially test rod one. This is given velocity V naught. Is asking what conditions will arise here. This is a rod one, rod two. B bar is present everywhere. And now when you give velocity V naught, negative flux increases, DeFi by negative, EMF induced, positive. Induced current will flow anti-clockwise. The induced current will flow anti-clockwise. And because of that, here, in what direction the current will flow? So I'll starting the explanation. I'm starting from here. So the induced current when the rod has come to this position. So what is the direction of induced current? Will be like this, and because of this the velocity of this rod start decreasing and the induced current I is flowing on this. So because of this current I flowing, B bar into plane, so it will experience a force. So how much of force? BIL. Here BIL will be like this. So then this will acquire a velocity V2. So initially V1 will be less than V2, but V1 will be greater than V2. Tell me what will happen. How long this motion of rod like this will take place? How long the motion of rod like this will occur? Because of BL force, continuously velocity of the rod 1 will keep on decrease. The velocity of the rod 2, what happened, will keep on increase here. At one instant, what happened, both will have common velocity. And once both have common velocity, then what conditions will arise? Both will have common velocity, then the net flux linking the loop remains constant. Though there'll be displacement of rod, net flux linking the loop remains constant, and because of that, what happened? No induced current will flow. What should happen to the distance between the loops must increase. Distance between the rods will increase. So you calculate initial distance, say some x naught. This should be x, and this x should be greater. They may ask you any very good conceptual questions. Finally, both will have common velocity. So let mass of the rods be m. Can I conserve momentum? Yes. What is the net force on the system along x-axis? Zero, no? So initial momentum, mv naught should be equal to mv plus mv. So v equal to v naught by 2. Initial kinetic energy of system, mv naught square by 2. Final kinetic energy of system, half mv square. So this should be mv square or mv naught square by 4. Now I am asking you, kf less than kf, where do this energy gone? What type of motion the rod one? Retarding motion. So where do that decrease in kinetic energy of system has gone? Momentum of system will not change. Momentum of system will remain same as it is. But kinetic energy of system here decreases. Because net force on system along x-axis is zero. So therefore I'm conserving momentum. Where do that energy gone? So something we should justify, no? Kf less than kf, loss in kinetic energy. So what are the possibilities? There should be some resistance. The rods will have some resistance, and that particular heat will be generated. There's only source, no? Or else, if you go for any other friction is there between the rails and the rod, they'll be utilized to overcome that friction, anything. So now delta K should be equal to heat generated. There's a possible source. So let me put some resistance for the rod. Very, very good questions can be asked. I'll connect spring between the rods and I'll project it. You go for further thinking on this one. Now similarly, this is a rail, circular rail, and this is a rod. This is a rail, and the initial position of the rod was here, no? Initially, the rod was exactly at the diameter. Read the question. Meanwhile, I'll draw the diagram. So this was the initial position of the rod. Finally, somewhere at x equal to r by 2. R by 2, I should take like this. B bar everywhere into the plane. So let this be x, let this be y. And this is the radius r. So you, a wire ring of radius, not for a rod, the ring is having a radius. The ring is a wire ring of radius are fixed in the horizontal plane. The wire of the ring has resistance of lambda ohm per meter. So we'll do one thing, we'll break up this everything into two parts. This is A, B, C, and this is D. Arc ADB will have one resistance, arc ACB will have resistance. Will I agree this? And this is a moving rod. It is given. Find the current through the rod as it traveled a distance x2. constant acceleration. It is moved with a constant acceleration, so therefore it will have velocity. So what is this entire circuit? You should directly come for this. The resistance of RADB. Moving rod will behave like a cell, Mankfield into the plane. B bar, so this end will be positive. So what is this resistance? ACD. Now calculate this. What is y? Y equal to x by 2, no? Y equal to x by 2. So we'll get the theta triangle. X by 2. This R. R by 2, sorry. This is R by 2. Y is equal to R by 2. It's asking a condition like this. Find the current through the rod at an instant it has traveled to a distance x equal to r by 2. This only. I think that x, this x will get confused. So we'll do one thing. I'll make it smaller. Cos theta x by r. R by 2 by R, theta will be 60 degrees. Now you know length of the rod. In terms of R, you can bring it. So what is the EMF induced? E is equal to BV into AB. Calculate the length of the rod at this instant. Then calculate EMF induced. And you can calculate the current in the circuit here. Can you work out this? It's very simple. Different types of rails, the rail parabolic, now here circular rail, triangular rail, already we have seen. So different conditions will come. So you should manage with this one. I'll upload in the end. I don't have answer. I have to cross verify it. So, and what is V further? A into T, acceleration as a function of time, velocity of the rod. So, do calculation. I just gave the idea, share the idea. So, we'll take the next one. Once again, I'm coming to rotational EMF problems. I read the question. So whenever that rotating rod, so what you should do, you should replace with a cell. No, so this is one basic methodology what we adopted earlier previous classes. At t equals 0, the cell, the EMF of the cell is switched on, then it's asking find the angular speed of the rod at any time t. So I'll do one thing, length L, resistance R. Okay, take this one. Now get into the problem. Where the resistance are for the rod, you can show it here. The rod will be resistance. That the initially when you switch on, the rod is not disturbed. It is there in that position, and the entire thing lies on the horizontal plane. How the MG will act into the plane of paper? Current I will flow. Okay, clear this. So when a current I flows in the rod from A to O, so will there be any BL force will act as BL force? That BL force will start rotating it, and as this starts rotating, then what conditions will arise? Then the rotating rod will behave like a cell. Then EMF will be induced. Then induced current also will come. Then the resultant current will decide in what direction it will move. So initially, so the moment you switch on, so what will happen is a current I1, I'll call it. This current I1 is due to the cell. It will flow in this direction. Don't show in the rings. It's of no use. No, B bar current I. So in what direction this will experience a torque? No, B bar the current. So if you take a small element of length dx, a torque will act in this direction. This torque acting about O will make the rod to spin, will make the rod to rotate about O. As it starts rotating, the rotating rod will behave like a cell. I'll proceed to the next part of the problem. Now in the same, this is called like a motor. A motor, oh, coming ring. No, tell me like what are things I should replace this with like a cell, no? This one, let's go for the cell. Let me draw a diagram. A cell will come. What should be the direction of EMF induced? As the rod rotates, B bar velocity, so this should be the polarity. Now the cell, what it will do? It will push the current in opposite sense. So I1 is in this direction. The cell will push current in this direction. Oh, it all got messed up. Fine, all of you. So why that I1, I2? So what is I1? I1 should be strictly what I should write. I1 equal to E by R. And that resistance also I have to show it. I'll show that resistance are here. Then what is I2? I2 should be E by R. What is E? B omega L square by 2R. And what about the angular velocity? Angular velocity of the rod will be in this direction. I don't have space. I'll show it here. Tell me initially which will be greater. E will be greater than small e. So which current will be greater? I1 will be greater than I2. Tell me what will happen to the motion of the rod altogether. Due to I1, the torque will be clockwise. Due to I2, the torque will be anti-clockwise. The resultant current in what direction will be? Towards left. Again, I'll go for one more diagram. I'm showing, let me show only this one. So the resultant, the net current in the circuit will be in what direction? Because I1 greater than I2, so the net current will be in the direction of I. The resultant current, let it be I, and it will be in this direction. Okay, now check it. The torque, it will be B bar and the current. How is the torque? Torque will be, the resultant current will flow in this direction. Will there be, what type of motion the rod is going to describe? Come in order, I1, due to I1, the torque will be downward. The torque will be clockwise. Due to I2, the torque will be anti-clockwise. And since I1 greater than I2, so what will happen to the rod? The angular velocity of the rod will keep on increase. The net torque will be downward only, or say clockwise here. Where is the Lenz law? I1 is the cause, I2 is a opposition. Able to manage? The torque due to induce, the torque due to current I1 is what? The cause will make the rod to rotate. And according to Lenz law, the I2 is what? I2 is a induced current due to induced EMF. It should oppose the cause. So therefore, torque due to I2 will oppose the cause. But the since I1 greater I2, the resultant torque will be like this only. Will be clockwise. Okay, let's come for the mathematics now. So what is asking? Angular velocity of the rod at any instant of time t. How to calculate that torque? I'll go back to the some basic formulas I told. So what should be the torque due to this overall current? B square L to power of 4 omega by 2R. Am I right? If you can remember such things, very easy for you. Or else what you should do, assume a small element, the force acting on the small element df, then d tau equal to df into x, then f equal to bil, bi dx, then integrate. Finally, you end up the same thing. Some of you are still asking, sir, how you're writing. I'll just show d tau equal to df into x. So this is bi dx. So this should be bi x square by 2, or the limit will be x dx 0 to L. Bi L square by 2. What is I? I is equal to total net EMF induced. So net EMF induced by the resistance R. So what is the net EMF induced? It should be equal to E minus E by R. You see net EMF induced. Net EMF induced E minus E by R. So further this, I is equal to E by R, and what is B omega L square by 2R. So can you write directly this much? The answer is no. Problem to problem, things will change a little bit. This is torque due to induced current only. If you substitute here, you get torque due to induced current. There'll be torque due to what? Applied EMF. Torque due to applied EMF. So therefore, you have to be very careful about what I said, like will help you. Slightly, it should be modified. I'll take it out this. Now come for this one. So what is the net torque should be equal to? Net torque. So there's a formula. Bi L squared. So here you are going to substitute here. B L square by 2. In place of I, E by R, B omega L square by 2R. Now write I equal to alpha d omega by dt will be the required answer. ML square by 3 d omega by dt solve for omega. So what should happen to omega? Omega should increase with the time. Again, you get a equation of this thing exponentially increasing after long time. The EMF induced in the rod will become equal and opposite to applied EMF. The current will be zero. Or this will be terminal velocity, you can call it. So what is the terminal velocity? Directly you can write it. B omega t L squared by 2. Please do learn all this. They may ask you to find the terminal velocity of the rod. So directly, after a long time, the induced EMF across the rod should be equal to applied EMF. Okay, see this now. So this mathematics, you have to be very careful. The induced current, this is the expression. Okay, fine now. So for in a rotating structure, then a cell will also come into picture. So go back to same motional EMF ideas is what we have applied it here. Let's come for this. Two conducting rings PQ of radius R rotates uniform in opposite direction with center of mass velocity. They're having rolling motion on a conducting surface. The potential difference between highest points of the two rings. Okay, let's directly come for this. If it is having only rotational motion, what is EMF induced? That the uniform magnetic field is there. Only rotational motion. What is the EMF induced between these two points. If a ring rotates in a uniform magnetic field, will there be any EMF induced in it? I'll come to the problem question later on. First, let's analyze here. Nothing is there. B bar into the plane. Let L be the length of the ring. This is a ring. I'll just rotate the ring about an axis passing through its center perpendicular to plane with an angular velocity omega in a uniform magnetic field. And now B bar perpendicular to plane of the ring and parallel to axis of that. Will there be any EMF induced in that? Will be zero, no? No EMF will be induced. So what is the rotational effect on the ring? What is the rotational effect on the ring? Though due to rotational effect, there won't be any EMF induced, the similar idea. Only due to translative motion it will come. Please do understand, this is the idea of the problem. The ring is rotating about an axis passing through its center perpendicular to plane. B bar is perpendicular to plane of the ring. Then no EMF induced in the ring. Come for this problem. They're having rolling motion. So due to rotational effect, there should not be any EMF, only due to translative motion. And only due to translative motion, what we do? We replace the ring. If only due to translative motion, there's everything. So how do it will behave like a cell, no? So what should be EMF induced? V 2R into this one. So this will be one cell. B bar out of the plane velocity. So this should be the ring Q. This is a point Q. Here B bar out of the plane. B bar out of the plane. So this should be the velocity. Now what should be the EMF? What is the length? 2R, no? So this should be BV 2R or 2, and this should be BV 2R, and this should be B 2V, and this is 4R. So 2V, B 2V, 2R. Diameter will become 4R. I am replacing this ring with two rods, and the EMF in the two rods is what I'm showing like this. So this should be again. It's asking potential difference from X to Y. So let me proceed like this. Vx, is it polarity okay? How to decide polarity? B bar velocity. B bar out of the plane. I think the left rod I'm bringing polarity, B bar out of the plane velocity. So this end should be positive. Yeah. For this ring, B bar out of the plane velocity. So this end should be positive. So I'll write it Vx minus B 2V 2R minus BV 4R minus VY equal to zero. No potential difference is set up. So due to rotational effect, no EMF. Due to questions of this kind, very important for exams. Due to rotational effect, no EMF. That one means if a ring, if it is having uniform pure rolling. Let me just describe the basic things. So there's a ring which is having a pure rolling, and another ring. Let me introduce forward slipping, backward slipping, all. V equal to R omega. V1 greater than R omega. V2 less than R omega 2. Forward slipping, backward slipping, pure rolling. And B bar is everywhere into the plane. What about EMF induced in all three rings? About what point? About point XY. Eight BVR minus negative of negative. Okay, sir. Yeah. Calculation mistake. Thank you. This one. Check it now. What about VXY in all the cases? Sir? Ring one, ring two, ring three. Anybody? VXY in all the cases. Will it be same or different? Due to rotation motion, no EMF induced, no? So therefore, V1, E1, E3 should be equal to velocities are different. Let me put like this. I'll generalize it now. This will be BV into 2R. R is the resistance of the ring. Is it okay? Forward or backward? Irrespective of that, due to rotation motion, there won't be EMF induced. Only due to translative motion. Please just be careful in exams. They'll try to test with all application part. Why two cells? Because this ring open, you can break up semicircle. No, this is one semicircle. This one semicircle. Due to each semicircle cell and carry on the problem. This is something related to SHM. So we have a capacitor here. This is spring. Initially at this particular position. So this is the initially equilibrium position. Spring is at natural length for this. Some SHM also can be asked. So let this be a rod. Now this rod is pushed by distance X naught. Let me take this as X naught here. So there's a rod AB as given, no? And I'll take it PQ. Because acceleration will be using symbol. So let me make it PQ. B bar into the plane. So what happened? The spring? Spring got compressed, no? In fact, the spring got compressed and I release it. So now there's a mean portion. So there's a natural length of the spring. I'll call L naught. What is L naught? L naught is natural length of the spring. This is very important. L naught is natural length of spring. Initially, what happened? The spring is at natural length. That's what X equal to zero is telling. I compressed it by X naught. I release it. Then we have to discuss the problem. I'll make it a little bit more. It's asking us to calculate the time period of oscillation. Little bit, some good observation you have to make it. Don't do for off cycle. In another off cycle, we don't know how the system will behave. When I release it, tell me what will happen. Spring force will act here, no? This is released from rest. Kx naught will act. And as it starts accelerating, it starts accelerating. then the moving rod will behave like a cell, then EMF will be induced, then the charge will get deposited in the capacitor, then the rod will accelerate, then we have to check it, what is the time period of oscillations. Okay, let's. In exams, I don't think so, you can draw so many diagrams. Huh? You have to be. So let this be at a distance x. It has approached near to the equilibrium. Let this be x, that one. This was the initial portion I released it. So now it got accelerated. So B bar into the plane, check it, which end will be higher potential? Which end of the rod will be higher potential? Velocity of the rod will be in this direction. Then in what direction the induced current will flow? B bar velocity. So this end will be at higher potential. This will be lower potential. So I can replace with a cell here. Let's have this one. So this will be Q minus Q. So the induced current will flow in this direction. So how BIL force will act on the rod? B bar current. So the BIL force will be acting in this direction. This is some extreme, right extreme. This is a mean position. This will be a mean position. What we have is right extreme. And what I'm giving is intermediate position. Okay, let's write equation for this. We know there is no resistance here. Look at the entire problem. There's no resistance. There's no resistance in the circuit. So what is the basic equations we can write now? Shall I scroll down? This is t equal to 0. This is at any time t. Now what are the equations of motion? Kx, the acceleration will be towards right. So ma equal to kx minus bil. No? And we know if a capacitor is there, what is q? Q equal to ce, or this is equal to cblv. Or this should be equal to I is equal to CBLA. So in place of I, I'll write CBLA into L. So bringing onto that side. So this should be M CB square L square into A equal to KX. Or what is A is equal to K by M CB square L square. And this acceleration is opposite to displacement. So I'll get the time taken, time period. Is it our answer? I think let it pass through the mean position. At mean position is the maximum velocity. And the spring, what happened? The elongation of the spring, the differential spring will be zero. Once it crosses mean position, what type of motion is going to discuss? The spring force will act towards right, no? Then now the BIL force will be acting, still be acting towards right only. Then it will undergo retardation, comes to left extreme. This is for, what is this acceleration from right extreme to mean position? Time taken to move from right extreme to mean is what I can predict here now. So this will be time taken, should be equal to 1/4 of the time period. 1/4, this will be 2 pi. Will I agree this? This is what? Time taken to move from right extreme to mean. Right extreme, I'll write symbol M. Once it arrives at mean, it will have maximum velocity. No? Then still what happened? The induced current will flow in same direction. But spring will get elongated. No? What is the state of spring? Compressed. You see, now the problem will change slightly. You have to be very careful here. Let's compound this. I'll keep total diagram. I'll make it visible. Check it now. See it. No, let it arrive at. The mean position will be here. They should not be there. No? Yeah. And the spring is compressed. A spring will be elongated, no? The spring force in what direction will act? In direction. But the induced current should be in same direction. BL will be in same direction. And now it will undergo retardation. Please, I think I can show only this much. You have to really understand these two diagrams. There's a mean position. There's a mean, and somewhere here will be left extreme. No right equation for motion here. Ma is equal to kx plus bil, no? And what is I? I is again same thing after substituting. This will be CBLA. This is it. So this will become M minus CB square L square A equal to KX. So what is A equal to in this case? KX by. Look at now. So what about this time period? Time period from mean to left extreme. This is the left extreme. How much it should be? 1/4 of what we calculate here. This will be called T dash. And what is T dash? T dash should be 2 pi M minus C B square L square by K. Are the time period same? No, for one off from right extreme to mean, it will have one time period. From mean to left extreme, it will have another time period. 1/4 of time period is what? This one. So now TML, you calculate. So this should be equal to how much now? 1/4, 2 pi. Try to see in the numerator. You have plus sign, minus sign. So in EMI chapter, you try to be careful about SHM. That's what one question I just brought it here. What is the total time period of the system? 2 times of this, 2 times of this. Agree, no? So time period T naught. So what is T naught? T naught should be equal to 2 times of TML, 2 times of RM plus 2 times of ML. That one. I'm very sure once students reach here, no? What they do? How? Okay, the same thing will get repeated for in left off. And they'll put answers same, but options are different here. So whenever in that EMI chapter comes, the SHM, you have to be very careful. Conditions of SHM comes, you have to be careful. So when you substitute all this one, you'll get the required answer, the time period. Time period of oscillations of the rod. Now, last one. Okay, read the question. So we have some loop here at t equals 0. So I'll rotate with a constant angular velocity. Thermal energy dissipated in the wireframe when it moves from region 1 to region 2. Total thermal energy dissipated in one cycle is asking all the conditions. So it's a very simple, already you know rod concept. So you do one thing, take this as rod. OA1 and this is OA2. Like two rods are rotating and they're connected by arc A1, A2. And angle subtended by that arc is pi by 4 at the center. I'll rotate it. So where all heat will be generated, there's no magnetic field here. And there's a field here. So I'll without any much calculations, you can end up this problem. So don't get into mathematics. Just treat like a two rods. It'll be much easier. So when the rod is here, when the rod is now, will there be any heat generated? No. Will there be any flow of current? There is no field here. The field here is out of the plane. The field here is into the plane and no field here. I'm making things clear. There's a region one, there's a region two. When the rod OA1 entering the region one, will there be any flow of current? Yes, it should be no. So replace this with a cell, no? It's very easy for you. B bar out of the plane, B bar out of the plane, B bar out of the plane tangent. So this end will be positive. The end O will be positive. So replace with a cell. So how much of EMF induced? Let it be E. So what is EMF induced? B omega L square by 2. So resistance R and the resistance R is free to rotate. It's also having a total resistance. Let it be R. I'll show it somewhere here. What is the expression for current? Call this current as say I1. Now again the same loop. Same loop when it comes here. So when it is entering here. I to draw another diagram. When the loop is completely inside, I'm just decreasing the size because I let me show it here. When loop is completely in the region one, will there be any EMF induced? Yes, EMF will be induced in individual rod. So what is the direction of that? It should be problem solving very easy once you understand this. Rest all very easy. And first what we'll write what is E? E equal to B omega L square by 2. No EMF induced, no? Again, no. When OA1 in the region 2 and OA2 in the region 3. So what is EMF induced? Here 0. Net EMF will be 0. EMF in the loop will be 0. Any reason for that? Plus C minus E. So when a current I1 will flow, when the loop is entering into the magnetic field or when it's moving from region 1 to region 2. So this is one thing. Similarly, let me show here only one. I'll finish off this one. Again, when it is coming out from region 2, B bar into the plane. Okay, tell me how the direction of induced current should be. Here, no EMF induced in the rod OA2. Sorry, this A1, this will be A2. B bar into the plane and the velocity. So this end will be positive. So this end will be positive and this will be E. And the current now will flow like this. Call this is I3 in this position. And when the rod is completely in the region 2, again, no EMF induced. So this is A1, this is A2. All of you able to get the polarity? The EMF, so this is the case here. So tell me when there'll be EMF induced, when it is entering from one region to other region only, when no field to field, or from region one to region two also. I'll take one more diagram. This is the loop when one rod is one region, other rod is other region. How the EMF in this should be like this in this direction, because B bar here is into the plane and the rod is having angular velocity omega like this. What about here? The B bar should be in this direction. What about the direction of induced current will flow in this way? So let me call this is I2. And the resistance R, I'll show it somewhere here. So net EMF induced will be zero. Okay, you have everything, this, and no need to calculate, no need to integrate. Just looking at the diagram, you are supposed to write the equations now. When there'll be current, when there'll be EMF induced, when the loop is entering from one region to other region, or when from no field to field, or from field, from field, it is coming out of the field, entering the field, or coming out of field, when one region to other region. What is I1? B omega L square by 2R. What about I2? 2 E nu, 2 times, both the EMFs will added up here. So therefore, what is the equation? I1 is equal to, I'll write it here. I1 should be equal to E by R. B omega L square by 2R. What about I2? I2 should be 2 E by R. Don't go for mathematics. Let me assume a straight flux linking that. This like just like a rod, no? OA1, OA2 are rods. Take help of that and wind up the problem. Now he's asking the thermal energy dissipated in the wireframe when it moves from region 1 to region 2. How much of time? So what is the angle? So what is this angle? Pi by 4, no? So what time it will take to move from region 1 to region 2? It is rotated with constant angular velocity. And a constant current I2 will flow. What is the angular displacement it will have? Pi by 4 radian. So can we calculate the time taken? Question number 153 I'm discussing. 153. So what is the time taken? This should be T should be equal to pi by 4 omega. Then what about the E generated? S should be equal to I2 square R T. So I2 square will be 2 B. So this 2 also get cancels. So B omega L square by R whole square into RT. What is the angular displacement it will have? Pi by 4 radian when the loop moves from one region to other region. Total thermal energy dissipated in one cycle. So where all heat will be generated? Here. Here and this one. So total heat generated, what we should do? I should add up, no? This is one, when it moves from one region to other region. When it is moving here, so I'll calculate. I'll do one thing, I'll call this H2. Now heat generated here, let it be H1, this be H3. How to calculate H1, H3? H1, H3 should be equal to I1 square R into, say, so let this be time T2, T1 added. So what is the T1 again? You can write same pi by 4 omega. This also equal to T3. time taken by the loop to enter fully into the magnetic field region 1. Same thing, pi by 4 omega, that one. So we got this much. Now you add up this, the total heat H1 plus H2 plus H3. Do calculation. So we should avoid mathematics. That's what I'm telling this one. So take help of the rod concept here. Things will be easier. Can we ask questions of these kind of? You have to be careful. Last one more. Or try this in, well, I'll send it in WhatsApp. No, you can try this one. Huh? So shall I end up the class? Okay, thank you all of you. Thank you all of you. Take care. Bye. See you.